can feel it in the air tonight. Do you feel it running through your veins? It's like kryptonite. Cause the sun is shining up above, and the night is just as young as both of us. So let's just stay together, make our own forever, be my guilty pleasure.
Welcome to my channel. So today we're going to be installing this hair together, and I'm just going to take you through the whole process. The hair is from Eunice Hair, and this is what the inside of the wig looks like. It has two combs at the side and then one at the back, and then the adjustable strap, which is like the regular wigs look. But this was so easy to install. The hairline looked like it had been blocked, or they tried to do something to it, and I feel like for some people this is very okay, they won't even touch it. But for some people who are more professional with this hair thing, they probably will still go into this hairline and, you know, just thin it out. But I'm just going to take you guys through the process of what I did. So I just, you know, removed the hair from my face so I could cut the lace. I don't think I've ever cut the lace on camera, but I realized that using this kind of scissors, the one that comes in a manicure or pedicure set, is the best to use. You can cut it on your head because it's very thin, but the bigger scissors are very difficult to use. You can also use the eyebrow trimmer, but I find that difficult to do on my head. This is just perfect for me. So now that we're done with that, your girl is just going to take some foundation like I always do. If you can do all the bleaching or the tinting, you can do that. I even heard that there are some sprays, in fact there are some sprays that you can just spray on your lace and they just tint your lace to, you know, a particular, this particular skin tone that you want. I think you can get them on Naija Naturals. So this hair came with baby hairs in front, which is a good guide for, you know, a beginner. So I'm just going to cut them short. So of course you can't have a lace front without having your got to be blasting free spray. So I spray that down, tied it down, used my hand dryer to just speed up, you know, the drying process. I think plucking of frontals is one of the most tedious or the longest process that you can do when you're installing a hair that has a frontal. So I didn't do too much of this because the hair looked pretty reasonable to me, so I just did the one I could do and then that was it. So I'm just going to lay down my baby hairs, which is one of my favorite things to do. I think this is my favorite thing to do, and the fact that this one already came with baby hairs just to help as a guide, it just made it perfect.
As the sun fades out, I can see clearly, and time slows down.
So I'm going to use my trusty TCB leave-in treatment. It has shea butter and coconut oil, and this is what I use on all my curly hair, and so far I'm loving it. It makes the hair very soft. So when it comes to curly hair, I don't like my curls tight, so I always like to brush out my curls with a brush or to just run my hands through them. So that's what I did here.
Yeah.
So this was very easy for me to install, and some hair brands like this make it easy for you, especially if you're a beginner or it's not something that you are into. This was very easy to do compared to the amount of work I put into this. The hair came out looking really good. So basically the hair is soft, it's good, it hasn't shed so much. I have some shed from it because I plucked some hair in the front. So in subsequent videos I'll let you know how this hair is doing. I might be taking it on my trip, I'm not too sure, but I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not subscribed already and give the video a thumbs up. I will see you in my next one.